I am taking a break from Fashion Week, but it's quite nice. You know, the only thing that's going to get me out at the moment is a fashion show for prams. I'm like, that's, you know, I'm looking at New York Fashion Week going, yeah, you know, all these models, they look a bit strange. Their shape's a bit odd because, you know, I've just surrounded myself with ladies with big bellies. So, you know, but luckily fashion happens twice a year. And in fact, it just never stops now. So, no, I don't think they'll miss me this season.
Even though you're taking a break, we can still talk about it. We're here celebrating iCandy's 80th birthday. For you, what does it mean as a brand?
I think they're very sleek. I think that, you know, the whole design perception of what's acceptable now within the kind of mummy land, it's no longer kind of like, oh, well, here's just a pushchair. They are now on par with a handbag. You know, you want something that's, you know, like your Audi Q5. You know, it's like the ultimate kind of thing. And design and ease of use is obviously something that has to be thought about. There has to be great technology in it. And people are really, you know, and there's like a lot of pram snobbery that goes on. Lots of pram snobbery. And so just having just a pram, it's not going to cut it, no. And with the amount of tweets I've been getting about, oh, you're going to have the best dressed baby. And I'm like, no pressure. But obviously I have to have a pretty chic pram.
All eyes will be on you and the pram and the baby when it arrives. Now, you spent some time on Britain's Next Top Model, working there as a judge. Can you tell us, there's been a lot in the papers recently, especially with Fashion Week coming up, on whether it's an industry that we should be encouraging young girls to get into, which raises a lot of questions. It's very interesting. So what's your opinion on that?
I think if you're naturally gorgeous and you're young, which the industry demands, then it's a great way of making money. To go further as a mega career, you have to be something else. You have to be a brand, and that takes a lot of work. Linda Evangelista can move nearly every single muscle in her face. So she knows exactly how to just cock an eye or move a cheek. So it is a skill. It's not for everybody. And I think that, you know, my experience top model is that it was so sweet. We'd go in the auditions, we'd go, so what makes you want to be a model? And it's like, well, my mum and dad say that, you know, that I should. And it's like, they're a bit biased though, you know, so it's just really knowing what it takes and knowing what a tough industry it is. It's really hard and really hard to get to the top.
For girls looking to enter the industry though, what would be the best answer to that question? Why do you want to be a model? What would you be looking for them to really say?
Me personally, I think you have to be at least 5'9". You know, the whole kind of Kate Moss is a like a miracle of her own working. She is a brand unto herself, being 5'6.5", 5'7". And so lots of people think they can get into the industry by being short because they go, but Kate Moss is. And it's like, you know, but that's a one-off. She was the zeitgeist at the time. She summed up the look of the 90s. And so be the right height. Be aware that it's tough. There's a lot of competition, and sometimes just pretty doesn't cut it. So, you know, be prepared to work incredibly hard for an incredibly long time. It's not as glamorous as everyone makes out. It's like, oh, I'm a model and just go to parties and stuff. You know, it's very hard work.
And you say Kate Moss, she was the look of the 90s. So what's the look of today?
Do you know what? I like to say that it's actually, there's been a kind of regeneration of older models getting back into the industry. If you look at the new M&S campaign, you've got Grace Coddington. Grace Coddington was a model here in the 70s, 60s and 70s, before she became a fashion editor and went to America. So what I'm really appreciating is seeing women like Kirsten McMenemy, Guinevere Van Cinas, she's been working for ages, and they're still, you know, it's not like every single time you see a teenager, you know, in a campaign. There seems to be a kind of real celebration of beauty of all ages. So, you know, even if people were models and then had kids, you know, I'd say, you know, don't be afraid of getting back into it if you feel confident enough.